So I welcome all of you to this discussion about the gaseous state. We are going to talk about substances which are gases at room temperature. Okay. Of course, some liquids have a tendency to easily become vapors like petrol, diesel. And such liquids which can easily become vapors are called volatile liquids. Vapors also show almost same behavior as gases. But technically here we are discussing largely about gases which are gases at room temperature. Now, there are so many elements in periodic table which do exist in gaseous state at room temperature. This is the list of gases. Though they have shown hydrogen in group 1 in the periodic table, really the position of hydrogen is uncertain. We don't know whether it is exactly belonging to first group or 70th group. But anyway, hydrogen, which exists as H2 gas, nitrogen of 15th group N2, oxygen of 16th group, it may exist as O2 or O3, ozone, fluorine F2, chlorine Cl2. These are all reactive gaseous substances. And inert gases which belong to 18th group, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. These are all elemental gases. In addition to this, you have gases like H2S that has rotten egg smell, N2O laughing gas, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, so many other gases, HF, HCl, HBr, HI, so on. All these gases have certain common features which you are aware of. First thing which you are aware of, gases are highly compressible. Yeah, one can compress the gas, because if you are decreasing the volume of a gas, it is your experience that the pressure inside will build up. And gases exert pressure equally in all directions. Pressure means force per unit area. Force exerted by gas molecules over unit area of their container. Third point is, gases have very low density. You know, density means mass by volume. The gases have much lower density than solids and liquids. The volume and the shape of gases are not fixed. They keep on changing depending on the nature of container you are storing in. And gases mix evenly and completely in all proportions without any mechanical aid. Even gases have a property to flow. Like liquids and gases which can flow, they are called fluids. Gases and liquids together known as fluids. And now we can today quickly look at some fundamental laws which are obeyed by gases. And these gas laws are strictly obeyed by ideal gases under all conditions of temperature and pressure. The real gases really do not obey all the gas laws which we are going to discuss under all temperatures and pressures. They obey the gas laws only under certain moderate temperatures and pressures. In fact, a gas which strictly obeys all gas laws at all temperatures and all pressures is ideal gas. No real gas is ideal gas. But as you see, all real gases show ideal behavior at low pressures and high temperatures. Notice, if you reverse the pressure and temperature conditions, then they don't show ideal gas behavior at all. In fact, an ideal gas can't be liquefied. But all real gases can be liquefied at a high pressure and low temperature. In existing gases, helium is somewhat closer to ideal gases, though helium itself is not ideal gas. We know liquid helium as well. But at the moment, we see the fundamental gas laws and under normal conditions, these gas laws are obeyed by many gases. The first gas law which we are going to study is Boyle's law. For a fixed mass of a gas, for a given gas, the pressure is inversely proportional to volume, which we write as P is inversely proportional to volume. At a constant temperature and for a fixed amount of gas where number of moles are fixed, P is equal to K1 into 1 by V, or PV is equal to K1. It means the product of pressure and volume of a given mass of gas at a given temperature remain constant. Remember, PV is a constant, is Boyle's law. It is strictly applicable for a fixed mass of a gas at a constant temperature. First, Boyle's law. You know, when a weather balloon is sent up, as the weather balloon is going up, what happens to its size? Size of weather balloon increases as it goes up, because when it ascends, the pressure drops. As pressure is dropping, volume of the weather balloon increases. The variation in temperature can be neglected. The second law is called Charles' law. But before we go to Charles' law, we can give a quick look at certain graphs relating to pressure and volume. This pressure and volume graph, which is plotted at a constant temperature, is called isotherm. Now, the PV graph is like this. It is also known as rectangular hyperbola in mathematics language. If you are plotting a graph for pressure versus 1 by volume, it is a straight line y is equal to mx type of graph, where T1 is less than T2 is less than T3, or T3 is greater than T2 is greater than T1. Now, one can take up the experimental data and measure what is the pressure of a given mass of a gas when this volume is this much. When I am decreasing the volume, the pressure is building up. So I can really work out how the 1 by V is varying and what is the value of PV. And I can always observe product of pressure and volume remain constant in a given set of experiment. But at this point of time, I want to say a graph plotted for pressure and volume at a constant temperature is called isotherm. Boyle's law graphs are called as rectangular hyperbolas, right? Now, you know, density is nothing but mass of a given gas divided by volume, mass per unit volume, right? Therefore, if you say volume is inversely proportional to pressure, density is directly proportional to pressure. It means if you are increasing the pressure, density of a gas increases. It is a consequence of Boyle's law. We will be looking at some problems a little later, but we quickly run this story. Charles' law is a law that relates volume of a gas and temperature. I would suggest this Charles' law like this. According to Charles, the volume of a given mass of a gas at a constant pressure is directly proportional to temperature. This N represents fixed mass and this P represents fixed volume. V is equal to K2T. So V by T is a constant. This is true for a fixed mass of a gas at constant pressure. Another point one can think, Charles has practically observed that volume of a gas always increases by an amount of its volume at 0 by 273 for every rise of 1 degree centigrade. So volume of a gas at T degree centigrade is equal to volume at 0 plus volume at 0 by 273 into T. It means volume of a gas at T degree centigrade is always greater than its volume at 0 degrees. It is more by an amount V0 by 273 into T. Right? This is another way to look at Charles' law. The graph plotted for Charles' law, the absolute temperature versus volume, is a straight line. Right? Now this graph, volume versus temperature, which is a straight line, the temperature is in Kelvin scale. Now the graph of volume versus temperature in degree centigrade is like this. This is called y is equal to mx plus c type of graph. This is the volume of a gas at 0 degree centigrade. If we keep on cooling, the volume goes on decreasing. At this temperature, minus 273 degree centigrade, volume of a gas tends to be zero. This temperature where volume of a gas becomes zero is called absolute zero temperature. This graph is called isobar. Okay, we will continue about our gas laws in the next session. Thank you.